Hello everyone, welcome to PathWave Model Builder, the one-stop baseband modeling solution. This video introduces a new feature, IMV table in MBP version 2023. The transistor's physical targets, like threshold voltage, are very important for device modeling engineers. In MBP, we call this type of target IMV, which stands for intermediate variable. And the IMV pages are one of the most useful features in MBP. The user-defined IMV targets are calculated from the IV curves. We can add the trend plots for the IMV targets from version 2023. Besides the IMV plots, we can also add IMV tables to MBP GUI and export them. Now, let's go to the demo. There are two types of table we can generate. This is a demo project with typical IV curves and default IMV pages. The single table can be added directly under the target. Go to MBP script and find the target we want to work on, for example, VTH. Right-click on the target and select New. We new a table and give it a name, say VTH table. The default selection is the single target table. Let's keep it. Column keys refer to the columns we want to show in the table. Besides W, L, and T, I'd like to add VDS, VBS, and VTH. We can select the input from the drop-down list. Well, here we are, the VTH target table. We can also filter the bias in the table definition. For example, I add VBS equals to 0, VDS 0.05 to the restrictions. View the table again, and we can have a shorter table to work on. This is the single target table, and we can also create a multiple target table. Go to the IMV node and add a new table. Let's select multiple target table this time. The drop-down menu shows all the IMV targets predefined. And we need to select the targets which will be used in the table. For example, ID Lin and ID Set. These items are assigned in the column keys we'll display in the table. View the table. We can see the different devices with ID Lin and ID Set value. This value is the measurement value that we calculated from the IV curves. Note that we need to ensure that the selected targets have the same instance parameters W, L, and T, and then those target values can go to the same line. Then we can also add a simulation value. Check the checkbox of the simulation value and view the table again. The simulation values will show in the column of s.targetName. Similarly, we can add an arrow, say relative arrow. And we can see a larger table with a relative arrow for each target. We can save the IMV setting and return to MBP's main GUI. Refresh the IMV pages and we will find the new table. The simulation and target arrow will also update when tuning the parameters. So we can observe the trend plot and target table together on the IMV pages. It's also easy to save out the target table by right-clicking on the table and selecting Save as Excel. We can also save the measured IMV target as a DP file. And that concludes this video. Please refer to the IMBP help file for more details on the IMV pages function and configurations. Download with the link in the description and try the new features today. Thanks for watching.